Uh-oh, that ain't got course when you go to fix the headphones. It comes on. So now we're live at Spreaker.com, and you can go to earlymorningmod.com. This is the Golden Debate Show. We'll be doing the Golden Show in a little while. This is our news slash talk show. Tony, got anything interesting to say to set it off?
I am back. I'm in full effect, and the levels are definitely...
The message is clear.
All right, well, let's get it in.
The Golden message is Debate clear. Show.
So that little synopsis you just gave on that new movie was pretty good. Do you want to give it again?
Are now taking
science.
War.
Okay. Shut up, Artie. It's just, this is science.
These kids, this kid named Ender, and
I'm just trying to wake you up, everybody. I'm trying to wake you up.
Advance themselves so they can become commanders of space fleets. And at the end of the movie, they're thinking they're going through this simulation for the final, you know, so he could become a battlefield commander. And when they destroyed the alien planet, they're thinking, yeah, you know, we won the simulation, but come to find out,
science.
They actually
the
message is clear.
And it was very...
So it's kind of Matrix, kind of in a way that reality is blurred and... In a, you know, a small fashion. Now I'm going
to
have to watch
okay.
it.
Shut up,
Artie. It's
more
just, this is science.
In-depth analysis, but I think that's interesting that the main character was fooled and duped. Kind of like Oblivion, the last movie that we've seen, you know, they thought that the drones were good, but the drones are actually bad. So let's get into it with our first clip of the day. It's our man, 2 Minute News.
Okay. Shut up, Artie. It's just science.
Hey everyone, and welcome to another episode of News in 2 Minutes, bringing you the news that you need to know every day. Let's begin. In an unprecedented ruling of capital punishment, over 150 members of the Bangladesh Rifles, a paramilitary border security force within the country, have been sentenced to death for their part in the 2009 mutiny in which thousands of servicemen took part in gun battles and control measures aimed at taking the power away from what was a newly elected government after years of military control. The United States Army publicly unveiled for the first time this week that soldiers are equipped with and using a pair of pocket-sized, highly technological drones on the battlefield. As India successfully launched its first unmanned spacecraft on a year-long mission to Mars, China quietly denounced the speed in which the country launched a craft into orbit, saying that joint international efforts were now needed to ensure stability and peace in outer space, as Indian officials denied that the launch was designed to make a point to other Asian nations that the country was quickly becoming a global superpower. Health officials in China are confirming a new case of the H7N9 virus in a young child with no known exposure to infected birds as the country tries desperately to stop the virus that currently holds over a 30% mortality rating with infected patients. Clashes with police are being reported as supporters and members of the collective anonymous groups have launched a worldwide protest of governmental corruption and widespread crimes against humanity on Tuesday, coinciding with the celebration of Guy Fawkes Day, an annual commemoration of an anti-government plot that is primarily celebrated in the United Kingdom. The mayor of Matsumoto City and a thyroid surgeon who spent years treating children in the Ukraine and Belarus after the Chernobyl nuclear accident is among the many physicians and scientists describing the warning signs of an ongoing nuclear crisis and possible nuclear holocaust. And to wrap things up, the United Arab Emirates is beginning the trials of 30 men believed to have formed an illegal cell of the Muslim Brotherhood. The Sun unleashed an empire solicitor in conjunction with yesterday's Farsight CME. A chemical weapons watchdog group is calling for the Syrian weapons stockpiles to be moved outside the country before they're destroyed. A mortar round slammed into the building that houses the embassy of the Vatican in Syria, and a 5.4 in Japan, followed by a 5.2 in the North Indian Ocean, completes today's quake watch. And that's it for this episode of News in 2 Minutes. Check back tomorrow for more news that you're aware of. This week's News in 2 Minutes is brought to you by the Full Spectrum Survival Team. Learn the skills needed to prepare for this.
Let's get into a little clip. It's Alex Jones. I gotta play him every now and then, even though I tell you to watch out for him.
It's Tuesday, November 5th. I'm Paul Joseph Johnson. This is Nightly News. tonight.
You are a shadowy subculture which may have encouraged a disturbed young man.
No kidding. Who else wants a job grinding?
Don't fear, everybody. Just stay golden.
ABC News implicates Alex Jones in the LAX shooting. And DHS hires a top secret security force. That's
the message
next.
Is clear.
The InfoWars Nightly
News. The message
news.
Is clear.
This is Pure Torture. Watching that con man slime bag of pus suck everybody dry.
Top story tonight.
Science.
DHS to hire top secret domestic security force.
Science.
The Department of Homeland Security is to spend $19 million on a private security force in Wisconsin and Minnesota. An armed unit
science.
That must have a top secret security clearance, according to an official solicitation. Now, we've reported numerous times on DHS hiring armed guards to protect government buildings in preparation for potential domestic unrest and food riots. But this one has a new twist, because the highly unusual
a lot of fear of
top
stuff,
secret clearance
stuff,
suggests
I'll,
that...
I'll mute this real quick. Some of this stuff has some real valid meaning to it. I mean, I don't know if you know the Alamo. You're familiar with the Alamo, right?
In Texas.
In San Antonio, correct? The UN now owns it.
How can you own a historical...
United States when UN is a global, exactly.
DHS is not merely seeking to hire armed guards.
The message is clear.
Blackwater-style mercenaries who will be engaged in some kind of clandestine activity normally reserved for foreign spying or military operations. So what are they preparing for? Well, the DHS itself offers it back.
More fear! More fucking fear-based knowledge! Buy beer! Buy water seeds! Buy water filter! Buy seeds with water filters already in it! Report that shit! Fear, fear, fear! There's a war on for your mind! That part's true, everybody! But I'm just gonna flip out, everybody!
Shooting. ABC News implied that Alex Jones was responsible for motivating the LAX shooter during a report introduced by Diane Sawyer.
That's on Alex Jones does a lot,
of big
by
government
way.
With violence.
I'm gonna wake you up, everybody. I should wake you up.
A disturbed young man.
The TSA has a thankless job.
Down there in one of those catacombs. There's other guys that they look like. I don't know.
Just don't make no sense, everybody.
Who wants a job groping men, women, and children all day?
Among some anti-government activists, the agency embodies a federal government that's too invasive, corrupt, and incompetent.
Like that.
So they basically insinuate that not only Alex Jones, but also anyone who stands up for liberty is an inspiration.
I don't know.
Florida motherfucker could have been crazy. You listen to some of this knowledge. This is earth-breaking real. It breaks the paradigms that the shit that you might think is real isn't real. And it might make you flip out. And this shit is so fear-based.
Obama himself recently bragging to his aides, quote, I'm really good at killing people.
Just like Jesse Golden, you should start flipping minds on it. Use this knowledge to your potential to be the best situation that the vampires just get weak.
Every single day.
You're giving them the power.
So as John Rappaport notes,
break it through the
this
darkness.
Is like blaming the murder of John Lennon on J.D. Salinger because Mark Chapman read Catcher in the Rye before gunning down the Beatles singer. It
like
completely
I said, a lot of the time
no
we give the vampires
whatsoever.
Too much power. We don't take
However,
ownership in our own faults.
I mean,
faults.
This tactic doesn't really Still work anymore. Though. The fundamental message of individual liberty will continue to resonate far stronger than any
the
number of
clear.
Dubious, lone nuts incidents exploited by the establishment to frame their political adversaries.
I'm just trying to wake you up, everybody.
Moving on.
I'm trying to wake you up.
Story. Arming TSA officers hits resistance on the Hill, reports Politico. And again, precisely as I predicted in an article written hours after the LAX shooting on Friday, union leaders are now urging that TSA employees be given guns, handcuffs, and the power to make arrests.
Jackie Mason joins us to make headlines when he called Obama a lying maniac. And you know what, Mr. Mason, how dare you say that? How dare you say that Obama lied to us and said that nobody'd be kicked off of the their insurance? Obama says he never said that, sir.
Well, what's happening is that this man turned out to be the greatest liar of all time, but he's been doing it since he became president. Everybody chose not to notice it because everybody felt a moral obligation to prove to themselves that that they're accepting him, that they're enjoying him, that they fear him, that he was some kind of a connection with godliness they're holding his
sentences, somehow
recognize him for what he is, a plain out not liar who has no conscience about saying whatever he pleases, no matter who he writes, no matter what kind of fraud is involved. Now everybody is watching him very carefully. Now everybody is really frightened. Now they saw it right to their face how they could be wiped out and literally destroyed by him. So
science.
Now they're ready for him. And now,
okay,
as soon as he makes a fucking move, the whole country, even some of his zealots on his side, are beginning to crack.
There's plenty of independent spirits in the United States, parts of Colorado, will vote on Tuesday on whether to break away from the rest of the state. Marina Portnoy has been to find out why.
In a state of 5.1 million people, democracy is failing the minority. And a battle to break away has begun.
We're trying to address kind of systemic issue within the country, which is this rural
versus urban.
11 Colorado counties, approximately 400,000 citizens, are voting on a ballot initiative that would pave the way for creating the 51st U.S. state.
The
urban areas can assert their will against the rural communities, and that it is like taxation, not representation, in that the rural communities don't have a voice to block the things that are being forced upon them.
Earlier this year, Colorado's democratically controlled legislature exerted its power by passing laws fiercely unpopular in the northeastern rural parts of the state.
This kind of comes down to a major part of Colorado wants to
historic gun control laws and mandating only rural areas to produce 20% of their energy from renewable sources.
A move
officials say will crush farmers and ranchers
have to do a
while
lot
also
with
raising
marijuana
the cost of electricity.
Urban legislators imposed one step
Texas was talking about this a couple years ago.
Constituents. One might call that tyranny.
In my 13 years plus of being a county commissioner, I have never seen folks this frustrated, this discontent, this feeling of disenfranchisement.
In addition to sending a message to lawmakers here in Denver, supporters of the 51st state say their ballot initiative also serves as inspiration for the many other U.S. cities and states with their own secession movements.
I get phone calls on a regular basis.
From Vermont and North Carolina to Texas and California, the U.S. has seen a rapid spike in secession movements blazing across the nation in the past decade as the United States has grown extremely divided.
I hope that there's a recognition.
This next one's pretty interesting. It's about Obama's killing nature in his proficiency at it.
12 campaign is called Double Down Game Change 2012. Got a lot of revelations that people are talking about.
I'm just trying to wake you up, everybody. I'm trying to wake you up.
And he's now, quote, really good at killing people. Now, that's in reference to the drone program. That's a little disturbing, given that that's not true in a couple
science.
Of different ways.
Okay. Science!
Okay.
Shut up,
Marty!
This is science!
The message is clear!
A little disturbing for why it's not true, which I'll get to in a second. But now, did he really say it? Can he really take these guys at face value? Look, Mark Halperin is an establishment hack.
I love gold!
So, if you take what he says with a grain of salt, I hear you, brother. Right.
I love my car coffee machine as well.
Look at this. Pfeiffer says on ABC's This Week, the president is always frustrated about leaks. I haven't talked to him about this book. I haven't read it. He hasn't
science.
Read it. But he hates leaks. In other words, there's no denial whatsoever that the president said that. Just saying, we don't like it when you leak that he said that. Why? Don't they like that? Well, of course, he seems incredibly callous. Because the reality is, he is incredibly callous about how drone strikes have been used. Now, let me show you what they've actually done. The Bureau of Investigative Journalism has noted this is just in Pakistan. There's also drone strikes in Yemen. This is the best they could do in counting in this area. They've killed between 2,528 people to 3,648.
Now,
among
down
those,
in one of those catacombs,
very conservative.
There's other guys that they look like. I don't know.
This don't make no sense
civilians.
To anybody.
Otherwise,
about
to be gone military.
I'm just trying to wake you up, everybody. I'm trying to wake you up.
They're military-age males, which is almost all adult males, to be terrorists unless proven otherwise.
So
in that conservative science. Estimate, 416.
The message is clear. The message is clear.
Now, if you're really good at killing people, did you mean to kill those civilians? Or maybe your statement isn't very good or very true. You're not very good at killing people. You often kill civilians. But the reality is, no matter how you take that statement, its core and why the White House is mad about it is the most important thing, which is this indifferent attitude towards killing these people. Now, if you have an indifferent attitude towards killing Osama bin Laden, I think a lot of people might understand that. But when you have anywhere between 400 and 900 civilians at least killed, including a grandmother that we showed on her family on the program last week, came in for hearings in D.C., her family did, blown to smithereens. Her grandson saw it with his own eyes, along with 18 other civilians. Oops, we killed them. So are you really good at killing people? Maybe you think, yeah, I am. I kill these people all the time. I don't give a damn if they're civilians or not, but I'm good at killing.
I'm just trying to wake you up, everybody. I'm trying to wake you up.
This is the Golden Debate Show.
President Obama had said in a nice speech.
Southern New Mexico at a Walmart, and he was pulled over for going through a stop sign. All right, so far,
science.
So good. Unfortunately, he was then taken to the hospital and forced to undergo anal probes and forced defecation by the police officers.
That ain't gold.
They thought they hit the ninja sack up the butt crack, dude. Buttocks, that is not cool. What he's talking about.
That's somehow a sign that he has. Enema, forced defecation. Doctors found no drugs. Jank, I know you're going to have a field day with this one.
Yeah. Now, look, when they're going into your cavity...
I'm just trying to wake you up, everybody.
Down there, what are those cattle?
So, now, look, they got a warrant, to be fair, right?
Yeah.
So, that's the upside of this. Like, yeah, how many of these stories have we done where they haven't gotten the warrant? I haven't done, like, I don't know the client's buttocks thing.
Excellent, bitches!
Thing near the border. I don't know that sometimes they
down in one of those catacombs.
Up there.
There's
right?
Other guys that so, they look like. I don't know! This don't make no sense to everybody. Shit.
Word up. Science!
Go to the bait show. Call Proud Zone, Truthful Tortellini. Earlymorningmob.com.
Word up.
Cash rules everything around me. Cream, get the money.
Here we go.
Dollar bill, y'all. Yeah. I grew up on the crime side, the New York Times side. Staying alive was no job. At second hands, moms bounced on old man. So then we moved to Shaolin land. A young dude, you're rocking the go-to. Low goose, only way I began to G-York was drug loot. And let's start it like this, son. Rolling with this one and that one. Pulling up gas for fun.
Hello? Oh, it's the Golden Show. Hit me up. Call the great 15 at yahoo.com. I'm on speaker on YouTube as well.
And the accused
gunman may have been a conspiracy theorist. Federal officials say he had materials referencing the New World Order. CNN's Pentagon correspondent Barbara Starr, she's live in Washington now. Barbara, let me ask you this. You know, do you know anything at this point what officials are saying
I'm
about
just
this?
Trying to wake you
well,
up,
some information is now emerging. Our Justice reporter, Evan Perez, has spoken to federal law enforcement official who says materials found on the shooting suspect did include a rant that appeared to reference that New World Order, as well as anti-TSA, anti-government claims. It's not clear what really gave rise to these references. Federal investigators have found no links to any groups or anything in the suspect's background to explain them. For people perhaps not familiar, New World Order is generally accepted to be a conspiracy theory where people believe that there are elites out there forming some sort of special authoritarian government. This is the generally accepted view of what New World Order means, but investigators
check this one out, Tom. This is going
to
be scary.
We have before us the opportunity to forge for ourselves and for future generations a new world order, a world where the rule of law, not the law of the jungle, governs the conduct of nations. When we are successful, and we will be, we have a real chance at this new world order, an order in which a credible United Nations can use its peacekeeping role to fulfill the promise and vision of the UN's founders.
Science.
We want to know, how safe do you feel America is from a terrorist attack?
I feel that we've stepped up our security since 9/11 has happened, and we're more aware of what's going on now, so we have troops around to protect us, and in case anything does happen, I think we'll be ready for it.
Honestly, I don't think it's very safe. I mean, you're always going to find somebody or something. Like, we could have a plane hover over our head and drop a bomb on us right now. But the security systems at the airports have definitely improved, especially on internationals, and I think it's getting much less of a threat than it was before.
Big Mickey Little, like, raising gray.
How safe do you feel America is from terrorists?
Jeannie Jasmine,
I think America is very safe from terrorist attacks.
I have 700 cats.
Because ever since 9/11, we've increased all forms of security, including at airports and other places where people come into the country.
Well, safe in the sense that I don't believe anything would happen, but not safe in the fact that people are always worrying about it, so...
Hi, everybody. On Thursday, I addressed a conference for business leaders from around the world, and my pitch was simple. Choose America. Invest in America. Create jobs in America. It speaks to my top priority as president, growing our economy, creating good jobs, strengthening security and opportunity for the middle class.
I think the numbers have gone up so high in terms of the number of people and the
amount. I think part of it is the economy. No one could deny that. There's serious rates of unemployment that continue.
Hi, everybody.
But this program also is rife with fraud. It has an outreach to bring people in. Another thing that they've done is get rid of the asset limits, which were traditionally part of this program. You can have $1 million in the bank. You're unemployed. You can get into food stamps now. That's an outrage. We also have weaker work requirements on this program than we do on the programs for single mothers.
One store quoted a price 40 times more than the other. How could that be? Especially when generic drugs are commonly thought to be so inexpensive.
I was shocked. I was confused.
I thought, what
am I missing? You know, this doesn't compute.
Thompson, who'd never been a consumer activist, said she felt compelled to try to figure this out.
I started just on my own to phone some other pharmacies in the Twin Cities here.
Last June, she made another round of calls like she did more than a year prior. And what she found was that nothing had changed. Wildly varying prices for her generic breast cancer drug.
How can I help you?
Hi, I'd like to find out what the retail price is for a 30-day supply of a generic drug called Letrozole.
$11 per set.
It's $29.88.
$45.99. It's $364.99.
$455.
It didn't seem fair, and it seemed to me especially egregious when it is on their life-saving lung cancer causes a heart attack.
But as long as they're making billions of dollars off of cholesterol-lowering drugs, they are going to sell them to you, and they are going to convince you that you have to take a drug to be healthy.
The message is
that
clear.
They taught me, as the rep selling the drugs, that, hey, guess what? You can lower cholesterol too much. And if you do that, you can wreak havoc in every other body system that you have. In fact, all of the clinical data shows that people with lower cholesterol levels, especially those over the age of 55, if they have lower cholesterol levels, they will die of other things such as cancer, autoimmune disorder. They can also have severe impotence. Well, they won't die from it, but it might be a major imposition.
I don't know!
This don't make no sense, everybody.
Now, you know your neighborhood. Keep an eye on your stranger taking a shortcut through the backyard next door and making into your neighbor's home. Report him, report him.
A strange car parked illegally might be loaded with stolen goods waiting to make a getaway. Report it.
That loud fight next door might be the start of a violent crime. Report it.
If you see a prowler at night, don't frighten him away by turning on a light. Report him.
Remember, by helping us apprehend a criminal, you make sure that you're not his next victim.
I talked to one woman who's head of retirement.
What's that?
And asked her if she was aware of studies that showed that index funds did better over time than the actively managed funds, and she says she wasn't.
That's unbelievable. I find that actually unbelievable.
These people that are in the business know that the index funds do better, right?
They convince themselves that's not true. When I've talked to these
people. But wait a minute. All the studies, how can they convince themselves that's not true?
Because they're convinced they're recommending the fund that's going to do better.
This is not a time when you want to be buying index.
And of course there are hot funds.
I'm just trying to wake you up.
This is not gambling. It's investing.
Year after year, financial media loves mutual funds fail to beat performing index funds. Studies have borne this out repeatedly over various time periods in bull and bear markets. I asked the head of retirement at Prudential, which markets dozens of actively managed funds, what she thought about this.
Yeah, I haven't seen any research that substantiates that. I mean, I don't know whether it's true or not. I honestly have not seen any research that substantiates that.
So all the research that's done at Vanguard that makes that argument, you look at it?
No, I haven't read everything. But it so much of it depends on, you know, what...
Oh. Yeah, I actually don't even think I
briefly mentioned in the other video was that our national debt.
The man from the River News is going to break down a little sound real quick. Tell me to go tell him
by $328 billion. Since the government has passed a law to reopen the government for another 2.5 months or whatever, allow the deficit to grow for 2.5 months, and then we're going to figure out what we're going to do about it in January this time.
Science!
Kick the can down the road. Okay. You know, you never
know. This is science.
So that's what they're going to do. That's what they've done. It's already a done deal. And as soon as they pass that law the next day...
Science!
Because we had some back payments, and we had...
I'm just trying to wake you up, everybody.
Government retirement program... behind the scenes, but we'll pay it back when the government passes a law, as old Timothy Geithner said many times.
Down in one of those catacombs!
There's no better place in the world to invest than here in America. And there's no better time to do it in many ways than right now, because some of the growth and development of the last few years has sort of equalized out in some places. So that manufacturing, as the Secretary said, the number of manufacturing jobs here now... going in manufacturing again, because it's
competitive.
The factors that will determine which countries thrive, as well as which businesses thrive, crystal clear that the United States is going to continue because it's the nature and base of our economy. Not because we're somehow superior or somehow better, we're just the nature of how we have grown, where we've come from, the Industrial Revolution all the way through the 1990s and the tech explosion and into where we are now. We will continue to lead the world.
The golden show. It's golden.
Round, dirty, round.
We're talking hood, draw the line, MC better talk with bitch chat, you know what's coming out the best, golden show, golden robes, golden boss, golden
What we saw was a segment about something called signature strikes. What they are literally are gunshots. Based on their behavior. Not who they are, not what they've done, not that we have any information about them. So literally some bureaucrat someplace is guessing that they might one day possibly be dead and be dead. This was the leadership of that community.
Part of the Golden Debate Show. The Golden Show. Check out our speaker, CryptoNateCRIPTOKNIGHT. Golden Show, Golden Debate Show, the Minimum Mile.com. Golden
are beyond that.